Well, frustration and outrage, a desert underwater, as the I-Team continues its week-long look into the devastating impact the housing crisis has had here in the Valley. George Knapp uncovers why many of you may be mistaken if you think that you own your own home. Dave sat down with him for a preview of tonight's story.
This series has been very interesting. Tonight, you turn your focus onto the banks.
It's sort of been a cavalcade of misery, Dave, if you've been watching it all week. The terrible toll that it's exacted on our community, more so than anywhere else, but everyone's been affected. Your home values have gone down 58%. Mine have as well. 63% of the people who live here underwater. And it wasn't an accident. This is systemic. This is systematic. The politicians took money from the banks. They deregulated the banks. They got out of the way. The banks said they were going to streamline this whole process. They privatized it, took it out of the hands of county recorders and started cranking out this mountain of fake documents. Robo-signers, mystery signers, documents that were filed out of order. The result is that millions of people out there, including many tens of thousands of people in our community, people listening to this right now, think they own their homes. They don't. If you bought a house out of foreclosure, even if you bought it from a flipper who got it out of foreclosure, there's a pretty good chance that there is a problem in the chain of the title and that you may not own the home that you've been paying on.
So what do we learn about the bank tonight?
Well, the banks have put this into the hands of these service providers, these third-party people who will handle all the paperwork. And they have done this blizzard of fake paperwork, signing documents that they have no right to sign, using fake names, fake titles. And the result is that every day in this community, people wake up and they realize, I don't own my home. I've been paying on this thing for years. I've been paying it to a mortgage company that does not itself own my home. And it is a shocking thing, and it happened to me. As I'm in the middle of this interview with the lawyer telling me this, she says, 9 out of 10 foreclosure homes have a problem. I said, oh, come on. I don't believe that. I bought a home out of foreclosure.
Right.
She says, give me your address. And I gave her the address, and she runs it. It takes her 2 minutes. She goes, bam, there's your problem right there. And it turns out the house I bought 3 years ago and have been paying on, I do not own. And I don't know how we're going to fix it.
Who's going to be able to sleep after they see your story tonight?
Well, I hope people will watch it, and I hope people really get angry about it, because that's what's going to take, is for everybody to get involved in this and get really ticked off.
Okay. The banks tonight. We'll see you at 11.
All right.
Thanks, George.